This piece is called Rebellious Silence, and it's the one on the right that is in the curriculum, but the one on the left is part of this the Women of Allah series. So I'm giving you two different views of Shirin Nishat's pieces. This is a photograph, and the photograph is taken by Cynthia Preston, but the artist is considered Shirin Nishat. Shirin Nishat was born in Iran in 1957. She studied art, though, at the University of California, and her fame rests on photographs and videos that will contrast Islam and the West, men and women, constraints and desires, the public and the private, the old and the new. And in the beginning, when she moved here, she kind of had a shock. 6 years after leaving Iran at the age of 17 to study in California, Shirin Nishat flew back in 1990 to visit her family. And Iran had completely and totally changed. The Iranian Revolution happened in 1979, and from 1979 up until today, it has been one governed by an Islamic government. And so Persian culture that had been based on some different values to Islamic ones was gone, and it was less stiff. The Persian culture is seen as more poetic and bookish, and more than anything, very old. And this new hardline government brought very strict, pure form of Islam to the country and wanted to erase Persian history and replace it with general Islamic culture. And this is a critique about from an Iranian American about the Persian culture and how it had changed to an Iranian one. So it's really part of a post-colonial discourse in art movement. Because there was increasing migration and the expansion of global communication and economies, there was questions of personal, political, and cultural and national identity that emerged in the 1990s, particularly for post-colonial artists that begin to address issues of contested identity, meaning they don't know if they're, are they American, are they Islamic, are they Iranian? I mean, there's all this stuff that she's dealing with. There's also the identity struggle within the whole post-colonial peoples, and to investigate the dissonance produced by transnational communication or even miscommunication between the colonizers and the post-colonized. Many of these artists, including Shirin Nishat and Rashid Aryani, speak with an unfamiliar but forthright and significant new artistic voice. Each of Nishat's Women of Allah photograph portrays both part of an Iranian woman's body, such as her hands or her feet, and overwritten with Farsi text and include a weapon. In her Women of Allah series, Nishat explores how Iranian women are stereotyped by the West. She created the series in the 1990s after returning from that trip, when she felt that she was in exile after the Islamic Revolution. She claims that their Islamic identities are way more varied and complex than what is frequently perceived. Each of her Women of Allah photographs portrays both, I'm repeating that, sorry. The quotes that are on here are from feminist women and writers. And in Rebellious Silence, the cold steel of a weapon part of that parts the woman's face or bisects the woman, and then the dark body into light and shade. And then her clothing and the weapon suggests both the women's defense of Allah in the revolution and also in the defense of their privacy and chastity in daily life. This woman is wearing a traditional chador, but her face is exposed and overwritten with calligraphy and bisected by a rifle barrel. Likewise, although the woman wears a chador, she looks directly and defiantly out at the photograph at us, meeting and returning our gaze. She challenged us to acknowledge her as an individual, and in this case, a strong and beautiful woman, but simultaneously and even paradoxically prompts us to see her as a stereotypical Iranian woman in a chador. In this image, there is a clear but ambiguous contrast between defense and attack, secrecy and exposure, eroticism and aggression. The range of imagery is kept within cultural, religious, and social codices of Islamic society. So Shirin Nashat is entitled to claim to have opened a pictorial discourse between feminism and contemporary Islam. She says, though, that she's not an expert, but just a passionate researcher. Her goal was to explore how Iranian women are stereotyped by the West, claiming that their Islamic identities are way more varied and complex than what is perceived. The calligraphy and rifle creates a sense of incomprehensibility or foreignness that prompts us to try to categorize these women. So the purpose of this is trying to confront our prejudices while also raising questions about the position of women in contemporary Iran.